Hello, career and college planning students. It's Mr. Kelly checking in. We are on day two of e-learning. Hope all is well with you and your families. You're staying inside. You guys are doing the right thing. Just wanted to talk to you guys about progress at this point. You guys should have already completed slide number one on this presentation. With slide number one being complete, that should have been the chance for you guys to pick the school that you're going to do your research on, getting the contact information for that school, which was not only the address, but the web address and the phone number, and the school's logo on your title slide. As I look through the progress, though, I am going to note, I have some people who have still not done anything. I have some people who did exactly what I asked you guys to do, and you guys are done with slide number one. And I have some people who are going ahead. Just a warning for those of you guys who are going to be going ahead, I have specific things and specific requests for the slides, so make sure you guys are still coming back and watching these videos to see if there's anything that you might need to change up, or just keep the pace that we're going. So for today's slides, you guys should be looking into how you can get yourself involved on your campus. And there's a lot of different things. And we're specifically looking at clubs and student organizations that you could join on your campus. So as you guys know, if you think about Baldwin High School, there's a lot of different clubs that are specific to either your area of interest career-wise or community service clubs. And it's very similar on a college campus where you guys can get yourself involved. In order to find this information, please do not use College Board. I'm going to show you why. If you guys use College Board, this is what's going to happen. You guys are going to come here, and you guys are going to go to the Campus Life tab. You're going to go to Activities. When you go to Activities, you see this little checklist here? It's going to be the same exact list for every school. And that would be boring for you guys to find that broad information when you could find much more specific information by using the school's official website. So if you guys go to the school's official website, you guys can come here. I went to Hofstra's website. I did a little searching around. I went to the search bar and typed in first. I did clubs and I did student organizations. On student organizations, I found it. It brought me here. And this is the list of the different student organizations that are available on Hofstra's campus. So please don't just list the first three because you're lazy. Find ones that potentially pique your interest that might be able to open up some networking opportunities for you, that might be something that you're passionate about, something that you can see yourself getting involved with to make your college experience a little bit better. And that's the whole point of this. So that's what I want you guys to do today. On that slide, I want you to find at least three different activities that pique your interest on that campus. List them, and of course use the samples as guides. If you guys have any questions, concerns, some of you guys have been writing to me through Google Classroom, some of you guys have been writing me emails, either way is fine. I'm going to say the easiest way is to shoot me an email, kellygr@boldenschools.org, that's kelleygr@boldenschools.org, if you guys have any questions. And other than that, again, I hope all is well with you and your family. You guys are staying inside, washing your hands, doing what you gotta do. All right, I'll be back tomorrow.